characterizes how some own-digit genetics change over time that doesn't involve the DNA sequence. And autism is a neurodevelopment that inhibits the communication and social skills. Specific info, autism signs include no expression by 6 months, babbling by 12 months, hand gestures by 12 months, words by 16 months, and no meaningful phrases by 2 years. As you can see right there, this wasn't one of the causes, but one possible cause is repetitive action, which he is by stacking cans on top of each other. Continuing, the human body adding to epigenetics can lead to a burnout of a protein called OXTR, which is the oxytocin. It's a protein responsible for bodily changes, especially in climate change. Without OXTR, the body cannot, it has to rely on other proteins. And now the body has to rely on pure hormone spore indica, which is responsible for the genetic makeup of the human. And without the DNA having this protein, the DNA would genetically change. And the research design, the purpose of the experiment is to observe epigenetics effects. Affects the developmental process of people who are using primates. But the hypothesis is that at least 40% of the primates living in San Jose, California will experience signs and symptoms of autism. The method is to receive 100 newborn primates from West Africa to observe in San Jose, California, and use another 100 primates to observe as a healthy control. And observing tested control groups for 24 months. I don't know if you can see this, but the results, the control group had a significantly higher results than the test group that only went to San Jose, California. One likely cause is because the OXTR did a burnout in a lot of primates, which forced them into autism symptoms. The significance of these results in this project determined the epigenetics increased the probability of developing autism 52% higher. Conclusion, my hypothesis was correct, epigenetics may cause autism to develop in childhood stages. In the next step of research, in 2015, a conducted study will be performed by doctors in Australia. They will use a new drug that strengthens the OXTR protein for longer endurance. If this study proves successful, this will become a recommended vaccination for infants and will be accessible to hospitals around the world. Acknowledgements are here. Any questions, comments, or questions? Mr. Jackson.
When will they not be conducting the experiment in 2015?
Because they need more time to gather materials for them to experiment in the study. Mr. Gunther.
Could there have been any other causes for the autism-like symptoms and the primates other than epigenetics?
There are other causes of the epigenetics, but this study was based on the epigenetics effects, not the autism effects based on. Yes, ma'am.
Maybe I missed this, but can you restate what the OXTR stands for?
The oxytocin receptor.